guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So today I woke up and I felt like doing a hair mask just because I wanted to wash my hair today. It's a little bit oily and I went to the gym, so I thought today's a good day to go to the gym and then come back and film a hair mask. Now this is my go-to hair mask. I honestly personally believe that this is the best mask. It contains so much good nutrients that you can easily just find from your refrigerator or from items in your pantry. So it's super affordable and an easy at home hair mask that you can make in the comfort of your own home. So I really wanted to film this video with you guys. So far what I did was I came home and I've already blended in this bowl right here a half of an avocado, and I also blended an egg in here. Yes, I said an egg, but the reason why I put an egg in here is because an egg contains a lot of protein, and your hair is made out of protein. So I threw an egg in there just to, you know, restore some protein into my hair. I, you know, color my hair, so this is not my natural color, and so I feel like when you color your hair, you know, you break down the bonds, you break down that natural protein that's in your hair. So I threw an egg in here, and then I threw in half of avocado. Honestly, I just put half. Number one reason is because honestly I think half is more than enough. The full avocado is not really necessary. And two, because I just wanted to eat the other half. I just came back from the gym, so I'm pretty hungry. So I'm saving the other half to eat it, and but I'm gonna do this hair mask first so I can let it sit while I eat. So then I'm going to add some olive oil. So I have a little container here of olive oil. I would say this is about maybe 4 tablespoons. Honestly, I always just kind of eyeball it. I really just, depending on how much I want in my hair. It's been a really long time since I made one of these at home hair masks. And my hair has been feeling kind of dry. The ends are looking a little bit sad, as you can see. So I felt like I wanted to use a lot of olive oil to really, you know, put some moisture back into my hair. So we're just going to throw that into the bowl. So just gonna put it in there like that, and then I'm going to mix it. Honestly, olive oil is so good for your hair. I love to use coconut oil too, but out of the two, I think I probably prefer to use olive oil. I feel like it adds like such a pretty shine, especially when I'm making this hair mask. I like to add some olive oil. I'll usually do, like, if I'm doing like a really, really quick hair mask, I'll just do coconut oil on its own. Otherwise, I'll use olive oil for this particular hair mask. So just make sure you mix it all up. Also make sure that you blend your avocado just so that you don't get like chunks of avocado in your hair when you're washing it, because let me tell you, I have done that mistake before of just like smashing it with my hand and it's still super chunky, and then it's so hard to get the avocado out of your hair. So you want to really make sure you blend it well. So once I've added my olive oil in there, then I'm going to add some honey. Honey is a great ingredient for your hair. It has so many good antioxidants. It also creates such a beautiful shine for your hair, and it just helps to restore that like beautiful health back into your hair. So again, I just eyeballed it. It really depends on your preference. It depends on how much hair you have, how long your hair is. Honestly, I don't even know how much this would be. I would say maybe like 5 tablespoons of honey is in this little container here. But again, it's totally up to you. And then I'll just put it in the mixture like that. Today I wanted to do a really intense mask, so I feel like I'm using quite a lot of oils and liquids. And plus I have a lot of hair and I have really long hair, so I tend to use a lot. So then you're just gonna mix that in there as well. And lastly, I'm going to put some castor oil in this mix. I didn't use as much as I did olive oil just because castor oil is, I personally feel like castor oil is a very thick oil, thicker than olive oil. So I think this is enough. I love to put castor oil in my hair. It promotes hair growth, and again, it just helps to, you know, replenish the hair with some moisture. So I'm just putting that in there. You just want to mix it really well. Make sure all the oils are mixed really well together before putting it in your hair. And I will be using all of this to put it in my hair, and I start from the roots and then I'll go all the way down to the ends of my hair. I think this mask is so good for your hair. It's rich in nutrients. It contains so many like good fatty acids for your hair, which your hair definitely needs. So if your hair is damaged, whether that be from the coloring your hair, whether that be from the harsh winter weather, the sun, or just by using, you know, constantly using styling tools for your hair, this is gonna be a great mask for you to do at home. I honestly just put it all in my hands. Get ready to get messy, because this is a messy hair mask, but it's a good one. And you're just going to put it all over your hair like that. Like, literally, you want to lather your hair in it. Just drench it completely. And I promise you, after you do this, your hair is going to feel so soft. It's going to look so shiny. It's gonna look amazing. So just keep doing that. So you also want to make sure that you massage the mask into your scalp, that way your hair follicles can really absorb all that moisture and start working its magic into the hair. Also, you know, of course, like, your hair grows from the scalp, so you want to make sure that you're also placing that nutrients in there and not just focusing it on the ends. Of course, I put it in layer by layer. I just sort of spread it all around with my hands, and again, just keep massaging that. Try your best in just sort of combing it out, because in that way you can easily spread out the product. So I tend to just gently comb it out, and I like to use like one of these combs, a really wide tooth comb, and that way you can distribute the product evenly all over your hair. So once you're done putting in the hair mask, you want to put it up in a bun, and you're gonna want to use one of these. So this is just a shower cap, and you're gonna want to put this on top of your head. And you're gonna look a little crazy for about an hour, but that's okay, because after, your hair is going to be luscious. It's gonna look beautiful, and it's gonna be worth it. So you just want to wear a shower cap. I like to keep it in for an hour. If you're a little bit crunched for time, half an hour should be good too. But to really maximize the mask and really see results, I would definitely recommend leaving it in for an hour. That's more than enough time for your hair to absorb all the nutrients. Maybe even do a workout in between, because that way when you sweat, you're creating heat, you're opening up those pores, and that way the hair mask can really absorb into your hair follicles. Otherwise, you know, an hour is good, and then you're gonna want to double shampoo your hair, double rinse it to really get that all out of there, really get a good clean. And yeah, so I'm gonna go eat now, and I'll be right back after I've showered, and I'll style my hair, and then you guys can see how my hair looks after. Okay guys, so I'm out of the shower, and I have been combing through my hair, and it's been so much easier to comb through. My hair is wet, but it already feels like so much softer, than it did before. It felt really nice, as you could just feel like the instant difference as you rinse out your hair. Yeah, it felt really good. Hey guys, so I just finished blow drying my hair. As you can see, there's the shine there. And my hair honestly feels so soft. I am so obsessed with this hair mask. It's super easy and it's like the perfect hair mask to do when you are in need of like a really good deep conditioning hair mask for your hair. So I think you guys are going to absolutely love this hair mask. It's like my holy grail mask. Honestly, just one day I just put all these ingredients together. I just did my research, went online and read on like what, you know, foods are good for your hair, and all these products that I, and all these foods that I put into that mix that you saw earlier today are all like rich in nutrients for your hair. So as you can see, all I've done is blow dry it and you can already see the shine. So I'm going to curl it now and then I'll show you guys how it looks once it's curled. Okay guys, so this is the finished look. My hair feels incredibly soft. I'm absolutely obsessed with how soft it feels, and like you can see just the shine in the hair. It's like so shiny. I'm obsessed. And like even the ends look better than they did earlier. I don't know if you guys remember from the beginning of the video, but my ends were looking a little bit rough and now they're looking as shiny as ever. This is honestly the best hair mask.
So that's it. As you can see, this is the final result after using the mask, washing my hair, curling my hair. I love the softness that my hair, I love the softness that it gave my hair. My hair looks super shiny, but most importantly, like I just cannot get over how soft my hair feels. It feels so healthy. It almost gave it that feeling of like a fresh new haircut. I would highly recommend trying this at home. So be sure to look out in the description box below. I'm going to be giving you guys a brief little overview of all the wonderful benefits of this mask and how it helps to, you know, really bring back that nutrients that your hair is lacking, and why it's so good to, you know, put ingredients like this in your hair. That's it for today's video. I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye guys.
Hey guys, be sure to check out my last video. It is a holiday lookbook. You don't want to miss it. The holidays are right around the corner, so I would definitely go take a look over here.